She's the diva dividing Australia, but there's no denying Delta Goodrem is hot right now. She's a coach on the wildly popular Channel 9 show, The Voice. And Delta's got yet another hit in the charts. She's already had 8 number one singles since breaking into the music business at the age of 15. No doubt Delta's enormously talented, but it's her tumultuous love life that grabs the lion's share of the attention. There have been the bad boy lovers, the cheats, even the recent teenage boyfriend. All the stuff that's normally ruled off limits in interviews. But when we sat down together recently, Delta announced, anything goes. And she actually meant it. Delta Goodrem is back home and center stage all over again. From Miranda to Melbourne, there's a hit song and a hit show. And while her fans have never forgotten her, in recent years, the girl with the stellar career all but disappeared. Where have you been?
Where haven't I been? I've been jumping around everywhere. No, I've been in LA and I have been in different parts of the world. I was in Bali songwriting. I was in Nashville songwriting for a while. I really went on a little journey around the world. And I'm definitely back, it would appear. I've been knock, knock,
knocking at the thought of your door. These days, home is Los Angeles, but this is her haven, the music room in the family's house in Sydney's Hills District. It's here that a 5-year-old Delta learned to play the piano and penned many of her signature songs.
That's your part.
So your music, as you keep playing,
is
you. The words are you. It's everything true. Comes through everything. Your songs and your music.
You want to know anything
everything
about
that's
me.
Here is in here.
Yes.
And in your music. And goes out to everyone.
Yeah. It's so they can hopefully weave around their lives like a soundtrack. I'm there for them. I want them to. I have these experiences so I can relate. Oh, that you see.
The world first met Delta 10 years ago as Nina Tucker in Neighbours. It was the perfect platform to launch her singing career.
Delta Goodrem, ladies and gentlemen.
And today, with 10 arias and 3 number one albums under her belt, Delta remains one of Australia's highest selling artists ever. Now at 27, she's got a new string to her bow as coach on The Voice.
Have a great show, babe. Have a great show.
Good to be here. It's incredible. It's very special. These new artists, you know, it's that first time people actually get to notice them, and I get to be there a part of that, and I get to be a catalyst for them to live their dreams, and that's just phenomenal to me.
But what Delta's discovered is that sitting in the big chair has meant no shortage of armchair critics. Her hair, her glasses, her clothes, even her tears have all been fair game for her detractors.
And the whole country was there with me, and I was really, really thankful for that. I've been hurt because I hate that my sincerity would be questioned, or I'm not quite sure where that comes from. It confuses me, and it's been a bit heartbreaking because I only want to do the best thing for everyone. I've only ever wanted to bring a good message through music. I accept that everyone has an opinion. I accept that. That's fine. I don't appreciate the personal attack because it's not like I don't think I'm offensive.
Have you come home sometimes and cry?
Oh, yeah.
Everyone, I guess, could look at you and sees this confident, beautiful woman. Are you that?
Be happy to know. I'm not feeling it.
Not feeling it?
No. I do what everyone else does. I have days where I get up and, like, I cancel training, or I, you know, and I eat too much chocolate all day, and my mum still says, clean up your room, and I've got, you know, I'm completely, you know...
Normal.
Normal. Don't I truly
believe? On set, it's last-minute rehearsals, a final chance to iron out any bumps.
Here we go.
We did it.
Right, go.
And when the show goes live, everything, both success and misstep, will become instant fodder for social media. And Delta's fellow coach, Seal, knows you've just got to rise above it.
That's the game, isn't it? That's the game. This week, for the last 2 weeks, it's her turn. It'll be my turn next week.
You're not going to cop anything, mate.
Of course I will. I mean, I've been doing this for 22 years professionally.
Come on, mate. You're like Teflon.
No. Well, the difference is, there is some truth in that. I'm older than she is. I mean, Delta has done a spectacular job. Mm. She is able to be a role model, but at the same time, be truthful, I think, is admirable.
Wasn't that long ago, you know?
That I was at school?
You know?
Yeah. Hello.
Certainly, there's no shortage of admiration for Delta at her old school, Hills Grammar.
You like the Pied Piper?
She still makes regular appearances here.
But I was born to try. I've learned to love.
This is Show and Tell, Delta Style.
Really come true?
I am. I'm so lucky. My dreams of one day singing in front of thousands of people in a room, one room, has been able to come true. So, yeah. What are your dreams?
To be famous?
No! No! That's it. You're coming with me. No!
I just wanted to know, have you ever lost your faith in love, and could I make you believe again?
I believe.
Heaven, I always loved you.
However, Delta's belief in love has been tested. Last year, after a troubled relationship with long-term fiancé Irish singer Brian McFadden, Delta worked up the courage to walk away. They'd met when she was 20.
It was a genuine love, and so I can't sit here and say it wasn't, because it was at one point. You know, I was very young when I met Brian. It lasted a long time. Yes, do I wish that it ended earlier? Yes, do I wish I had the courage to leave earlier? Yes, I do. I think what we came to is that we were very different people, extremely different people.
How was your heart when that all ended?
Oh, like anybody, you know. But in saying that, I think when your heart's been broken so many times along the way, that by the time it really is over, that you are, I was exhilarated with, you know, the anxiety of freedom as well.
Freedom?
Yeah, I was really, on one hand, it was a real relief as well, yeah. And then I jumped into another relationship that was completely different.
Mm.
You know, so
can you want to talk about
that's
that?
That's what it is. You can talk about anything, Karl. I'm whatever. Let's just talk about everything.
That relationship was with American musician Nick Jonas. And at 8 years her junior, let's just say it was a tad controversial.
A 19-year-old?
I think he was 18.
18? I'm sorry.
No,
what was that about?
Maybe it's that I'm interested in challenges. Maybe I'm one of these spirits that's always sort of, what is this lesson here? What am I learning here?
Did you fall in love there?
Wow.
Said I could ask anything.
Yeah, it's true. there was a genuine love, you know, definitely. You know, my dad actually said to me recently, now the next person you kiss, now you're not allowed to fall in love with them, okay?
Are you worried that you won't find the right bloke?
Oh, no, it's not even on my radar. Like, it's really, like, I'm just so...
Over it.
Yeah. I'm really, like, Karl, I'm just... I'm not looking for that right now.
So yeah, coming in here, mixed emotions.
Yeah, it's a very private.
But in the trials and tribulations of Delta's life, one battle stands above all others: her fight against cancer.
Hi there.
Hi Delta. My name's Ross.
Hey, Ross.
Lovely to meet you.
Lovely to meet you too. I hope that's your second day.
And the same problem you had, apparently.
Yeah. We're in the same club.
Same club.
And you'll get out of the club.
I'm sure of that.
The chemotherapy ward at St Vincent's Hospital in Sydney is where Delta was treated for Hodgkin's lymphoma when she was only 18.
And did you have total hair loss?
Oh, completely.
Complete.
Yeah, yeah, I used to stand there, you know, pulling it out.
Delta's now been cancer-free for 9 years. But like all cancer survivors, the experience stays with her.
It's hard because I think I feel differently about it at different stages. Mm. I think like as you get a bit older, I realise that you get more emotional, I think, about it.
When you come in here and you see people at the start of their journey, you know what they're about to go through.
Yeah, absolutely. I only ever want to be a tower of strength, so I hate getting upset, and I know that people don't need anyone to see upset, but it's just because it's life and it's real. And
I know that you kept a diary. When you look at that diary now, what do you see of yourself?
But this diary was, it's really, really fascinating because I think I learned how to swear in it. I think you start, I don't think I'd ever said a swear word in my life, and then halfway through, we find out the usage of some swear words.
Bad girl.
Not as unbelievable, just disastrous.
Do you remember when you were 7 and the only thing that you wanted to do was show your mum that you could play the piano?
Throughout her ordeals, Delta has turned to music for therapy, playing it, writing it, performing it. And even with her current hectic schedule, she's working on the next album.
I'm not a craver of anything else but making great music, so I tend to go back into my little hermit shell and do that, then come back.
Where's Delta go now?
They never know. Never know with me. Continue to make great music for people. That's really what I want to do. And get back on tour and sing for people.
Delta is irrepressible. Her enthusiasm simply infectious.
Oh, you made me cry. You know I'm a silk, you all know.
She's grown up before us, a childhood star, now simply a star. And she'll keep making her way through the strange and at times unforgiving world of fame as best she can. I
want to make Aussies proud and continue to learn and put them in songs. And do music forever, really. That's what I intend to do.
Delta got a voice back?
Delta has her voice back.
How corny was that?
Terrible.